boundary conditions. Okay, so boundary conditions means the conditions that about the behavior of magnetic field B and H at the interface of two media of different permeability. So we first consider boundary condition for magnetic field B. Okay, the lower part is medium 1 and the upper part is medium 2. Permeability is mu 1 and permeability is mu 2. And let us consider a pill box. The shape of the pill box is cylindrical. Upper two surfaces, this is the surface, second surface, this is the first surface, S1, S2. These surfaces are flat and circular, but the side surfaces are curved. This is S3, and the curved surface has the area 2 pi dh, where dh is the height of the pill box, and it is very, very small and may be considered as zero. Okay, N1, N2 are the unit normals to the interface. Okay, so this is perpendicular direction and this is perpendicular direction. So unit normals N1 is equal to minus N2, and again surface S1 is equal to minus S2. Okay, so in medium 1 the magnetic field is B1, which enters with making an angle, some angle theta, and leaves with some different value. This is B2 and with an angle theta 2. So we have to find the condition. Okay, so this is the perpendicular direction, which is perpendicular to the interface. So this is normal, and along this direction, if we consider this as the origin, so along this direction, so we can consider it the tangential direction. Okay, so we can consider tangential direction. So we start with the relation divergence of B is equal to 0. We know it. So the volume integral, volume integral of this divergence of B, this is the volume of the pill box, dV is equal to 0. Now apply the Gauss's divergence theorem, and this theorem converts the volume integral into the surface integral. Okay, so or the closed surface integral S1 plus S2 plus S3. So the pill box has three surfaces. The pill box has three surfaces, S1, S2 and S3. So divergence can be replaced by the surface integral is equal to 0. So here we apply by Gauss's divergence
theorem, by Gauss's divergence theorem. Okay, so this can be written as, so S1, this is for medium 1, we have B1 dot DS1. Now for surface 2, S2, and this is in medium 2, we have B dot DS2, and this is B dot DS S3 is equal to 0, but DS3 is 2 pi DH, and again DH is very very small, so the contribution of this term, so the contribution of this term is almost 0, and that is why we have only these two terms. Okay, so the first term after integration gives us B1 dot S1, and the second one gives us B2 dot S2 is equal to 0. Okay, now so now S1 is equal to N1 S1, okay, and S2 is equal to N2 S2, and N2 is minus of N1, so this is minus of N1 and S2. Okay, so using this, this can be written as B1 dot N1 into S1 plus B2 dot minus N1, so we can write it minus here, N1 and S2 is equal to 0, but S1 is equal to S2 and the magnitude are same, so that we have B1 dot N1 minus B2 dot N2 is equal to 0. Okay, B2 dot N2 is equal to 0, because S1 and S2 both have the same surface area. Now suppose this is the tangential direction and this is the normal direction and this is the magnetic field B. Okay, so that we can decompose the magnetic field along the tangential component, so this is BT, and along the normal direction this is B. Okay, so B can be decomposed along the tangential direction and along the perpendicular direction. Okay, again the normal is in this direction, so B dot N is basically B normal component dot N, B tangential component dot N. Okay, but tangential component and the unit vector, the angle is 90 degree, so cos 90, and because of this, this term is 0, so we have only the normal component. Okay, and that is we can write as B1n normal component of B1 minus normal component of B2 is equal to 0, or this can be written as B1n is equal to B2n. Okay, so this is the boundary condition. So this is the boundary condition of magnetic field. Okay, so that we can write, hence the normal component of magnetic field is continuous at the interface of media. Okay, so the normal component of the magnetic field is continuous at the interface. So what is the normal component? So let us consider a triangle. This and this, and another triangle. This. Okay. So this angle is 90 degree, and this angle is 90 degree. So the normal component is this. So B1 cos theta 1. So the normal component is B1 cos theta 1. Similarly, the normal component in medium 2, B2 cos theta 2. B2 is the magnitude of B2 vector. B1 is magnitude of the vector B1. So this can be written as normal component, that is cos theta 1 is equal to B2 cos theta 2. Okay. Now we discuss the boundary condition for magnetic intensity H. Okay, so this is medium 1, permeability mu 1, medium 2, permeability mu 2, and we consider a closed loop A, B, C, D. This is a rectangular loop such that CD, vector CD, is equal to minus of AB, and BC is equal to DA, and this is very small, can be considered as 0. This is the tangential direction and this is the normal direction. Normal to the surface, tangential to the surface. Surface means the interface of the two media. Okay, so this is the field H1 in medium 1, field H2 in medium 2. Okay, and we start curl of H is equal to JF. Curl of H is equal to JF. Free just current density, free current density. Now apply the Stokes' law. So that curl of H ds is equal to JF ds surface area,
and this surface area can be converted to the line integral. Or this is the closed loop A B C D A B C D A H dot dl is equal to this is called the IF. This is the free current IF. Okay. Or now we can split AB. This is H1 dot DL. This part is AB. Now this is the B to C, say H dot DL plus CD H2 dot DL plus DA H dot DL. Since BC is very small, DA is very small, so this is 0. One more thing, this is equal to or H1 dot AB after integration from here, and from here we have the value H2 CD is equal to IF. This is the value of this integral. Now replace CD by AB. So H1 dot AB, since CD is equal to minus AB, so minus of H2 dot AB is equal to IF. Okay. So AB is magnitude, AB is equal to AB, and this is parallel to the interface, and the interface, this is the unit vector T. Okay. So that H1 dot T minus H2 dot T into AB is equal to IF. Okay. So again, the magnetic intensity H can be resolved into the horizontal direction and into the perpendicular direction. So perpendicular direction, if we take, so this can be written as H1 normal component plus H1 tangential component. So T is perpendicular to H1N. So this is H1N, this is H1N, and T is along this direction. So this is 90 degree. Okay. So after taking the dot product, so H1N dot T will give us 0 because the angle is 90 degree. So that we have only H1T minus H2T is equal to IF by AB. IF by AB. Okay. What is this? if we have a surface and the current IF is flowing, and if this is the length AB, then IF by AB, the perpendicular length to the current flow, and this is a sheet, two dimensional sheet, and it will give us surface current density KF. So this is surface current density. Okay, so let us write it. H1T minus H2T is equal to KF, where KF is the surface current, is the surface current density, is the surface current density. Okay, so if the surface current density is zero, if KF is zero, then H1T is equal to H2T. That means tangential component of magnetic intensity in medium 1 is equal to the tangential component of magnetic intensity in medium 2, and this is called the boundary condition. And we can write it that, so if free surface current, free surface current density KF is equal to 0, then the tangential component of magnetic intensity H is continuous. So what is the tangential component? This is normal direction, this is tangential direction. So if this is H, so this is the tangential component HT. Okay, so if this is theta, this is also theta. So this is normal direction and it is cos theta, and this is sin theta. So HT is equal to H sin theta. So the relation, this relation can be written as H1 sin theta 1 in case of medium 1 is equal to H2 sin theta 2. Okay, again we derive that B1 cos theta 1 is equal to B2 cos theta 2. So divide this relation with this relation. So we can write it as, so now B1 cos theta 1 by H1 sin theta 1 is equal to B2 cos theta 2 by H2 sin theta 2. Or this is, and we know that B1
d by h is a magnitude is equal to mu. So b1 by h1 is equal to mu1 and b2 by h2 is equal to mu2. Okay, and so that this is mu1 cot theta1 is equal to mu2 cot theta2. This is another important relation. Okay. So, if mu1 is greater than mu2, if mu1 is greater than mu2, then from this relation we see that theta1 is greater than theta2. That means if the permeability of medium 1 is greater than the permeability of medium 2, then what happens to the magnetic field lines? This is our medium 2, this is our medium 1. So here is B1 and this is B2. This is the normal direction. So this is theta 1 and this is theta 2. So the field lines moves, so the field line moves toward the normal. Okay.